Do you feel the world is broken? We do. Do you feel the shadows deepen? We do. Do you know that all the dark will stop the light from getting through? We do. Do you wish that you could see it all made new? We do. Is all creation groaning? It is. Is a new creation coming? It is. Is the glory of the Lord to be the light within our midst? It is. Is it good that we remind ourselves of this? Lion of Judah, who conquered the grave. He is David's root and the lamb who died to ransom the slave. Is he worthy? Is he worthy of all blessing and honor and glory? Is he worthy of? Does the Father truly love us?
He does.
Does the Spirit move among us?
He does.
And does Jesus, our Messiah, hold forever those he loves?
He does.
Does our God intend to dwell again with us? Is anyone worthy? Is anyone whole? Is anyone able to break the seal and open the scroll? The Lion of Judah, who conquered the grave. He is David's root and the Lamb who died to ransom the slave. Every people and tribe, every nation and tongue, he has made us a kingdom and priest to God to reign with the Son. Is he worthy? Is he worthy of all blessing and honor and glory? Is he worthy? Is he worthy? Is he worthy of this? He is. He is. Is he worthy? Is he worthy? He is. He worthy, he is worthy, he is.
Guys, what a great performance, man. Just really special. I don't know that we'll ever get to see that again. I hope we do.
We need to take that on the road.
Yeah, that's right.
Right here.
But super special. You guys sound great together. But maybe, Chris, we'll start with you. This is such a special song. Mm-hmm. Talk about this a little bit and just your experience with it. When you heard it, what would make you want to put a song like this on your record?
Well, I've always loved Andrew as a songwriter and Ben. And this is just, when I heard this song, it literally floored me. Daniel, who plays guitar with me, mm-hmm. you know, he sent me this song, sent it over, said, you should hear this. I think you would like this. And he sent it to me, and I immediately, man, tears just started getting in my face. I was like, I have not heard a song like that that makes me just want to get on my face, like, and just worship Jesus. And it's been just so, impacted me so powerfully. And so I immediately just started writing to Andrew and said, you know, first of all, well done on this song. But also, is there any way you would, I maybe could record this? Because I would love for anybody who listens to my music, any kind of platform God's given me, I would love for everybody to hear this song. I think this is a song that is so special for so many. It's so wide and so special for the church. And I love that the whole song just asks questions, right? And what I realized in this song instantly is that it's one thing, it's powerful to say he is worthy, but to say, is he worthy? And to really think about that and that there really is only one that is worthy. And there's a line in there that says, is anyone whole? Is anyone worthy? Is anyone whole? Mm-hmm. And we think about all the things we run to and we all in this world, and we just run to broken things. Broken people trying to help broken people. And there's only one person that's really whole, that's going to make all this right.
Wow.
And he is worthy. And that just, this is all from Revelation, the scripture. And I think this will bring people. I've had so many people respond to me saying, Chris, I'm in tears listening to this. I'm on my face listening to this. Mm. I just want to get down and worship Jesus. And that's what you want. That's the way you want a song. That's what you want in a song. And when I heard it, I knew it did that for me. So I thought, if it does that for me, maybe it does that for other people.
Wow, that's amazing. Andrew, Ben, first of all, well done, man. Super beautiful. Maybe start with you, Andrew. Just talk a little bit about, it's such a unique song because it is a call and response, and just engaging the church in this conversation about who God is and how good he is. But talk about the song and how you guys started together, just maybe the thoughts behind writing it.
Sure. Well, the church that I go to, it's pretty liturgical, you know, which I like because it means I can't ever fall asleep during the service because you're always being asked to engage. You know, it's not like somebody's just talking at you, but you're also like responding. And I think I'm struck by how good it feels for us to tell the truth to each other, you know, during a church service. It's not just a pastor telling me the truth. It's like, no, we're all gathered here and we're affirming together what it is that we believe to be true. Telling each other the story again and again. And so I think the song started with a voice memo. I was driving down the road, and I have it. It's really funny. I would never play it for you, but it's pretty funny little voice memo where I go, he is. And I didn't even know what the question was going to be. I just kind of liked the idea of a back and forth. And so Ben and I were in the studio making my latest record, and which is about the resurrection of Jesus. The whole thing is focused on him and the triumph of not just the cross, but of the fact that he conquered death. And so all of the songs were kind of swirling around this idea, how do we bring glory to Jesus for this thing? And so I remembered that little voice memo, and I had written the verses, you know, do you feel the world is broken? He is, and I didn't know where to go with the chorus. And then I remembered that one of my favorite passages in Revelation as a kid, you know, a lot of kids, I'm a pastor's kid, so I was reading Revelation to try to figure out how much time I had left before I was in real trouble. And so Revelation was always fascinating, partly because it had dragons in it. And so anyway, I remember that there's scene, this amazing, dramatic scene where the prophet says, he asked the question, is anyone worthy? Who can be found who's worthy to break the scroll? And it says that he was weeping loudly, that he could not, that there was no one who was worthy to do this thing. And all of a sudden, you know, I think it's the elders, they stop him and they say, no, there is one who is worthy. And Jesus appears and just kind of strides into the scene. And then there's this beautiful song that all of heaven sings, praising him. I'm getting choked up now thinking about it. And so that kind of like, the fact that there was a question that was asked out of brokenness and despair and confusion, and then the resounding, like thundering answer was just the person of Jesus. Like, it's him. He is the answer to this thing. So anyway, that's kind of where it came from. I'm glad that it moved
you. Wow, that's so amazing. Well, let's teach a little bit, because there's a couple ways we were talking about you can approach this song. I mean, there's that signature piano part, Ben, that you wrote on this song, and then there's the simplified version that we were talking about beforehand. It's like, man, if churches are going to sing this, you know, we've got to show them that it's a very simple song to play as well. You don't have to be able to play like Ben to be able to pull this off. But maybe, Ben, we could start with you a little bit. Just maybe walk us through kind of a little bit of like the structure and the piano parts. And then, Andrew, maybe we'll move to you and you can just give us the
Chris Tomlin version.
Yeah, that's right.
I wasn't going to say that.
It's more than four chords, we're in trouble.
That's right.
Yeah, it's not a piano part that I could teach in a few minutes. So it's like, I mean, what I would say about it is that it's really, in some ways, it's just doing this. It's like this left, right kind of a thing, so that it's, you're just always going back and forth between your left and your right. But that's about as simple as I can make it. It's a bit of work, but I would want to underscore that at my church, we've been doing this song, and many of the worship leaders don't play the piano part, partly not because they can't play it, but because it's a bear to sing it and play it, and you don't want to have to like concentrate all your focus. Like, I played it, and I did the piano part, and when it was over, I was like, I think everybody else just enjoyed that more than I did, because I was having to work so hard. So I would just want to underscore that you could play this song as quarter notes and sing it, and it would be great. You know, it has been great at my church when people have done it that way.
Yeah,
I hope that's helpful.
Yeah, it is helpful. Andrew, walk us through just chord wise.
Sure.
You're capoed on, is it two?
I'm capoed on two right now. I recorded the song in B on my record because I am a baritone, and then Chris, I think it's an E on your record, right?
Yeah.
And so we kind of met in the middle and did it in D just now, which works. But yeah, I just capo two and played in C. I think C is the easiest form to play the song in because it gives you a lot of open notes, you know? So I just, whenever I've performed the song or led the song and I didn't have a piano, I just capo, you know, for B or whatever, I put it in the right spot. And I just kind of strum it really straight. It's just C, A minor, F, and G, and then there's an E minor thrown in there every now and then. So do you want me to actually
kind of
sing a part of
that.
It? So,
do you feel the world is broken?
And then we do, which by the way, I would say that Ben had pointed out earlier that in his church, they've done the song several different ways. Sometimes they do the actual call and response where the person on stage is asking the question and then the congregation responds, which is how I do it when I play it live. But then you said that sometimes you guys do it and you guys just sing the whole thing. You sing the questions and the answers, and that works too, which I think is pretty cool. So anyway, so do you feel the world is broken?
We do. Do you feel the shadows deepen? We do. But do you know that all the dark won't stop the light from getting through? We do.
So that's just C, A minor, F, and then back, then G, and back to C. And then the weird, do you wish that you could see it all made new? Is an E minor. So, and that's all the verses. They're all the same.
Yeah. Same thing every time. And when he goes to the chorus, starts on the four? Is that right?
Yeah.
Is anyone worthy on the four? Is anyone whole?
Five.
Is anyone able
six
to
minor.
Break the seal and
one over three.
Open the scroll?
Four. So that's...
Oh, no, that's six minor, five.
Six minor and then one over three. But you could go either way, really.
You could.
Yeah, you could just simplify it.
Is he worthy? Is he worthy? Is he worthy of this?
So, yeah, it's just A minor, G, then the C over E thing. It's just you. Like, I don't have to really move. I'm not used to teaching songs. This is pretty interesting. Clearly, I don't know
what
I'm doing.
You're a singer. You're not a teacher.
But it's it's just it's four chords. It couldn't be simpler. And I'm kind of a nerd, and so I'm always like trying to make things more complicated than they need to be. So I was shocked when this one all came out, and I was like, oh. Yeah, it's only four chords. It's not, or five, I guess, maybe.
Yeah. Well, lucky for churches, we'll have all the chord charts. Everything will be available.
So
we actually, if they can't make sense of all this, they can just go get
it. And if
the
they really want, they could get a video of me in a choir robe just going, we do, just to show on the screen.
That would be amazing.
Yeah.
Amazing.
Well, guys, thanks for coming and sharing the song with us. Chris, it's going to be amazing.
I'm so excited about
it. Just a great special moment on your record. And we really appreciate you.
Thank you,
by.
Andrew and Ben. I'll say publicly in front of everybody for letting me record this song.
Yeah, absolutely. Thanks, guys. Really appreciate it.
Thank you.